Welcome to teachtechtoe, a YouTube channel that bridges the gap between intellect and science. Once again, welcome to our YouTube channel teachtechtoe. This is our new video on machine learning with RStudio, in which we will understand all the basic tools which are required to perform machine learning operations on RStudio. So let's begin. First, I'm going to open my RStudio. I have now opened RStudio. Now, what I want to do is I will go on file and I will open some of our projects. These are some of the data files on which we are going to work on in this video, like startups, churn modeling, mall customers, market basket optimization, salary data. These are various data sources through which we will take the data, import them in RStudio, and we'll perform machine learning algorithms on them. Secondly, we'll first begin with data pre-processing. So how it is done, let's understand it with practical now. Data pre-processing. So that, let's say a CSV file that we have taken from any data sources, but that file is unstructured or improper. So what our first goal is to make that data properly arranged and remove the bugs, errors, or any missing data from that, so that we can perform the good machine learning algorithm operations on that data set. So here, to import the data set, the operation which we have to first perform is data set equals to read.csv, and in this round bracket we have to put the location of our file .csv. Once we will run this command, it will get imported. Now the next thing, taking care of the missing data. Which data is missing there? So for that, here we are pre-processing the data. So data set, let's first view that data set, what are the values that data set is having. I will just write data set, and you can see that data set is having country, age, salary, and purchased or not purchased. So France, Spain, Germany, Spain, age, salary 72,000 and so on, purchased or not, no, yes, paste. These are the data or data set. Now, taking care of the missing data, for that I will just run this command now. So if else is dot not available data set dollar age, av data set dollar age 1 equals to function x mean x na dot rm equals to true data set dollar age. With this if else command which we have used, this operation is being performed. Next operation which we are going to perform on salary. First we have performed that operation to remove issues from age. Now in salary, if else is dot not available data set dollar salary, same code we have run here, and salary data we have taken. Now encoding categorical data, we have to encode them. To encode them, the code which we are using here are data set dollar country equals to factor data set dollar country levels equals to C. In C, multiple values we can put, three countries are there, France, Spain, and Germany. Labels equals to C, 1, 2, 3. We have naming them France, Spain, and Germany as 1, 2, 3. Labels we have done. Now, data set dollar purchased equals to factor data set purchased. Country previously we have taken, here we are taking purchased or not. They are values either no or yes. We have labeled them as 0 or 1. And France, Spain, and Germany we have named them as 1, 2, 3. So if I will run it, that's without any error, these codes have run. Now, next important thing, the package which matters a lot in RStudio. CA tools is a package which we use now. If you don't have installed it in your PCs or lappies, you have to run this command install.packages CA tools. Once this is done, you have to just call library CA tools and run it. When you will run it, if it's running properly, then you can perform your operations. Set.seed equals to 1, 2, 3. Split equals to sample.split data set dollar purchased. Split ratio equals to 0.8. Training, we are training the data set with CA tools here. So training underscore set. Subset data set split equals to true. Test underscore set. Now we are creating a subset. of the data set like Python. And finally, after training the data set, feature scaling, which we are doing, training underscore set 2:3 scale training underscore set comma space 2:3 test dot set test underscore set comma space 2:3 equals to scale test underscore set comma space 2:3. Now if I will call the data and I will run it, because this data set we have named it, so I will just run this data set now. It's having total 10 values. Now let's compare the new data set and the previous data set. The difference that had occurred here in both of them, let me zoom it to make you clear. Initially the countries were France, Spain and Germany. They were not in numerical form, so that it was difficult to analyze such data. Similarly, purchased, they were no and yes. They are also in text form. Salary here is not available. To remove all such issues, we need to data pre-process. And once we will do these things, which we have performed the operations on the data set, the new data which came is not purchased as 0, purchased as 1. And country 1, 2, 3, which we have defined here, France, Spain and Germany were labeled as 1, 2 and 3. And no as 0 and yes as 1. And this data set we have got. Okay. Age also. Previously it was the Spain or the 7th person's age was not available, and age were in the form of simple numbers 44. But in the new data set, the age had also changed and they are in a better form. In decimal form, they have changed. So to get more better predictions, and the 7th person's age is also visible now as per the prediction. So this is how the data pre-processing is done in R. Now we will move next step and learn new things and take the new data set, and we'll understand simple linear regression. You might be familiar with that, no need to explain you more about that, but still we'll just revise that so your doubts get cleared. I will just clean this. Simple linear regression, just remember that linear regression answers the simple questions. Can you measure an exact relationship between target variables and a set of predictors made by those target variables? In our last videos, we understood the basic example of marks of students, number of hours they have studied with that, like that. The simplest of probabilistic models is the straight line model. How it is done? Let's check it out. We are taking the new data set here, which is salary underscore data. So for that, I am just running this command dataset equals to read.csv. That CSV file, we are gonna read that file. Once it is done, I will call again the data set to make you visualize that data set. After importing that data set, we can see this data set, years, experience and salary, 1 to 30 years are there, experience from 1.1 to 10.5 in increasing order, and salary is also in random form, but still it's also in almost increasing number, but some values are missing and some are improperly arranged, so we have to take care of that and make the predictions. So once again, I am using the same library CA tools which we have used last time also to convert the data into readable form to do data visualization and apply data science and machine learning operations on that data set. So library CA tools I am once again using here. Set dot seed equals to 1, 2, 3, which splits the data. Now split equals to sample dot split data set dollar salary comma space split ratio equals to 2 by 3. So I will run this split now and check. The output is shown as true, false, true, false, false, true, like this. Again, we are training the data set to perform machine learning operation on that, subsetting the data set, split equals to true. Test that data set, split equals to true, we are putting here. Subset of that data, subset, you might be familiar with that, set of a set, subset from true false, only true values and false values you have selected. Now fitting simple linear regression on the training set, we have to just fit the simple linear regression on the training set. For that, regressor equals to LM, formula equals to salary and years experience. We'll correlate salary and years of experience with that from the data training underscore set, which we have created this here, training underscore set. Remember the initial data set was named as salary, but we changed it and new data subset of that data set which we have created, it is training underscore set. So we have run this, it's also running without an error. Now predicting the, if I will run here regressor also, I will get the output. You can check that. Intercept 25592 and years experience is 9365 total. So we have created this regressor to get this output. Now predicting the test set results on from the given data set. Equals to predict regressor comma new data equals to test underscore set, we will test that set with this command y underscore pred. Let me run y underscore pred now after this and let's see what output we get here. With years of experience, salary is shown in the output. But if it's not properly visible to you, linear regression operation that we have performed on the data set, which was having the years of experience with corresponded to the salaries of the employee. So library ggplot2 I'm using here, which is used to visualize the data. But it's now running, that means we can use that library. Now we are creating a ggplot. For that, this command is use jom underscore point aes x equals to training underscore set with respect to years of experience, y in y axis we are going to put training underscore set dollar salary, color we are giving here as red, it's up to you whichever color you want to select with this command. This command will give point, put the points on the salary data and this would create a line which would be drawn. The points are the values which we have, but the line would be drawn in corresponding to that dots, which will connect those lines, sorry, to points. Now this GOM geometry underscore line ASX equals to training underscore set, same data we are taking here, and predictive analysis we are also performing here with linear regression, and new data training underscore set we are creating, color equals to blue I am giving, and GG title. With this command we can just put the title of the data which we are going to see in the output when we will run this command. In X lab it will print years of experience and Y lab it will print salary. So if I will just run this, you can see this means the plot is getting plotted and the right of bottom right it will get plotted. I will zoom it and visualize it. So salary versus experience will get in the result as the output. This employee and this employee and their years of experience and their salaries they are these. So if you want to give the person who is hired and he's having 10 years of salary and he's getting hired in your company, and we want to make, what salary would be the most preferable one to pay him? Otherwise there would be in politics in the office and other employees won't be happy that you are paying him more as compared to us with our experience. Why are you paying him more? Such, in such issues could be solved with this data. If you will visualize that data, and with this much years of experience, this much salary is appropriate for the new employee who is having 11 years of experience or 12. So to predict the results, this line is drawn, and these are the data sets, various data sets, and this is the line. This line is having number of maximum number of dots that could be drawn. The lines could be drawn, many lines could be drawn, but this line is the one which is a straight line and which can carry maximum number of dots in it as per the given data. Okay, and these dots are created with the current employees and their salaries, their year of experience. So this line will give us the most accurate salary for the employees which are going to get newly hired. Polynomial regression functions fits a polynomial regression model to powers of a single predictor by the method of linear least squares. Interpolation and calculation of areas under the curve. As I have told you that the curves are drawn, and instead of straight line, the new curves are drawn on the given data set. This time we are taking same data set of the salaries. Let me run it and visualize our data. What is the difference between this new data set? We'll check that. Here the position, the level and salary of the employees are taken as the data. Business analyst is the bottom most position and CEO is the top most position. And here the graph of the higher post from 1 to 10 increases. And these are the salaries. They are also in increasing order. So in this data, we are going to perform polynomial regression. With this command, data set equals to data set 2 to 3. From values 2 to 3 we'll get the data. Again, if I will run now, data set, does it make any change? See, now the position is removed. Only level and salary are shown as the output in the data set now, from 2 to 3 with this. So this command we have now used here to remove the position, because this one is 1, 2, 3. So 2 to 3 we are getting the values level and salary. It's clear to you? Okay, then now fitting linear regression to the data set. So again we are gonna perform the linear regression on the given data set. I will run it. Let me clear this one, otherwise you have any issue with that, you can just move the current plot with this. So fitting the linear regression to the data set, we will fit this, but I have not visualized that data, so we can't view that right now. But still, if I will write here what we can observe here is coefficient, intercept and level of the data set which we have taken. Now we are going to fit polynomial regression to the given data set, level 2, level 3 and level 4. Data set $level2 equals to data set $level this symbol 2, 3 and 4. All three we have done for fitting polynomial regression to the given data set. So this commands we have run here. Now poly underscore reg regression equals to lm, formula equals to salary, data equals to data set. I will once again run it, and now we are going to run poly underscore reg. If I will run it, we have got the new output, the level 1, 2, 3, 4 which we have created, 2, 3, 4, they have been seen here now. Initially the level was 80,879. This time level 1, 2, 3, 4, the coefficient, intercept, level 1, 2, 3, 4 have changed. That we have observed. Now we are going to visualize the data set for obtaining the result. For that, again library ggplot2 we are going to run to get the better output to visualize the data. Now we are plotting the data on the given statistical data set which we have got as the output, which we have seen with poly underscore regression. See, what problem here occurs is we can see the statistical output, but to visualize that data set is important, otherwise it's hard to make some prediction for data scientists. So now ggplot plus geometry underscore point AES, x equals to data set dollar level, y equals to data set dollar salary we are going to put here, color we are going to get it to is red, point we have created, line as we have created on the data set, and for this prediction we have run this command on and created new data set, color blue we have given to it, title x labels title and y labels title, level salary and level we have given. So with this command I will run it and the new plot will be plotted, which will show us polynomial regression visualization form, which would be seen like this. I will zoom it now to make you visible. Once again the line is drawn, but these dots, they seem to be curvish, and there's a line. So these were the result of linear regression, but since we are performing the polynomial regression here, because linear regression is not suitable to be fitting in this data set, because here the posts also matter a lot. Maybe experience is not that much important, but the position is also important here to get the salary and level of job. 10 is the highest level, so it's getting paid highest salary and it's in getting a bit. So this is the most proper line which we can create as a linear regression. So but a good data scientist who need to make some prediction, he would see that here we need polynomial regression. So again ggplot plus, here this time we are creating polynomial regression. So what is the difference between linear and polynomial regression in terms of codes? Can you observe that? Let me zoom it and see the new output with polynomial regression. When we have run this command, this code, there is a new polynomial regression which we have performed. So if it was linear regression, the output was this one. But on the same data, when we'll perform linear regression, now polynomial regression we're going to perform on that data, it had changed. It's covering more dots and nearer, more near to the dots this line is created. So here, to provide proper salary to the employees, we need polynomial regression on the salary data set, which can give us the more accurate result to make the predictions for the salaries of the employee. So predicting a new result with a linear regression, if we will run that, it is 330,378.8. This is the salary that we are getting with the level 6.5. The employee with this much salary and this post of the job with that experience, that is his predicted salary. Same employee salary, if we'll observe with polynomial regression, for that we have to run this command on the data frame. Now if I will run this, come on, the salary would differ. It's 1,58,852.5. So there is a difference between polynomial regression and linear regression. What are decision trees? Decision trees are versatile machine learning algorithms that can perform both classification and regression tasks. They are very powerful algorithms. They are capable of fitting complex data sets. Besides that, decision trees are fundamental components of random forests, which are among the most potent machine learning algorithms which are available in today's world market. Decision tree, for example, let's say we had a big data set of the visitors on our site. So we can say that number of male visitors, number of female visitors. Out of those male visitors, we need to get the data that how many of them are having age greater than 10 and lesser than 20 who had visited our site. So with decision tree, we can make the prediction that the number of visitors from, let's say, 20 male female we have separated first, and from male from 20 to 30, 30 to 40, yes, no, no, yes, and finally we can make the prediction from taking that data set. Let's do that practical now. And how to make decision with decision trees? This time salaries data again I'm taking position underscore salaries, the CSV file we are taking. Once again we'll see that data set. Same as the previous one, we are taking again. Again, the same two values we are taking. Again, I will call the same data set. Level of jobs and salary. Now we'll move to decision tree. The basic commands we have run now already. Here the new package which we are gonna run is library rpart. If you don't have that, install.package library, and in that way you have to just call that. But because we already have it, we just need to run library rpart. Once it is done, that means it's, this package is available to us. Now the regression we are gonna perform as rpart, formula equals to salary, data equals to data set, control equals to rpart dot control, minimum split equals to 1. from this data set, which we are calling data equals data set comma control. Salary data, we are taking formula equals salary correlated to dot equals to R part dot control. Minimum split equals to 1. Now predicting a new result with decision tree regression. Y underscore predict pred equals to predict round bracket regression comma space data frame level equals to 6.5. See the salary, if you remember this, these are the level of job posts. 10 is the highest, 7.55, 2.5. This is, these are the various levels of their job roles as per their experience and their job posts. So if the level is 6.5, which is unknown because the data which we had already, there 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, that values were also there, but 6.5, it's a new one of the person with this much salary, I mean his experience and his post. So that salary will increase because he's having a bit more experience compared to the one who is having 6. So to predict his salary, we can get this output. So y underscore pred, if I will call, his salary should be 2,50,000. We got that as the output. Now to create a ggplot to make the decision to know the salary of the employee with that experience and that job role, we'll just visualize that data also. To build data set to smoothly visualize graph in higher resolution, x underscore grid equals to, because salary paying should be in decimal form, so to visualize it we need to get more accurate output in dot decimal form. So x underscore grid equals to sequence SEQ minimum data set dollar level comma space max data set dollar level equal comma 0.1. this much accuracy will get in the result. We'll call x underscore grid, so that kind of output in the array form we will get. But again I will say that is it good to just know this output? Can we visualize that output in the decision tree form? So once again, ggplot we are going to form geom underscore point aes data set dollar level, y axis data set salary, color red we are giving here, in x equals to x underscore grid, y equals to predict regressor new data data dot frame, color blue we are getting here, title of that decision tree we are giving it truth and bluff decision tree, x label level plus y lab salary. We run it. So it's got plotted. So in linear regression there was a line, in polynomial regression something curvish thing was there, and this time the decision tree is made. So this kind of graph is plotted. So what observation can we make with this decision tree is, it also gives us on some, it varies on different data set that which is the most suitable result that operation is giving to us, machine learning operation. Here also you can see truth and bluff decision tree. So there is also a straight line, then it's moving ahead, and this one, so on this highest position the straight line is drawn. Here also where salary is 5 lakh, also because single person is also there, that salary he is getting, single line is drawn. here also. So this line is quite similar to, you know, box plot kind of thing. The centermost value you are getting here among these values. Among these values also, this is a values we are getting, and this is how decision tree works to make the decision. But remember, these x underscore grid, that data had, which we had got as the output of the operation to make the decision tree. So once again, let's remember, decision trees are very powerful algorithms capable of fitting complex data sets. That's why decision trees are fundamental components of random forest, which are among the most potent machine learning algorithms available today. On unpredictable data also, decision trees can make good predictions. This is the USP of decision tree. Now we'll understand multiple linear regression. Before we have understood linear regression, now we'll move ahead and understand multiple linear regression. Multiple linear regression, they are more practical applications of regression analysis. They employ models that are more complex than the simple straight line model that we have seen in the linear regression. The probabilistic model that includes more than one independent variable is called multiple regression models. Here also, we are going to perform the operation. Let me clear the previous data. Again, now I am taking a data of startups, 50 startups, CSV file I am importing. Let's see that data set, what values it is having. Around 50 values are there in that data set, which consists of RD spent, administration, marketing spent, state profit, companies, their state spend, in how much they spend in the marketing, their administration and their research and development spent, how much they have spent on them. Again, the same command we are going to use, 2 to 3. So with that, this time if I will run this command, which values will take? 2 to 3 means administration, marketing spend and state. So if I will run it, and call the data set again, the set operation would be performed and we will get new values. Administration and marketing dot spent. Now data set dollar state equals to factor, where labels C, New York, California and Florida, we are naming them as 1, 2, 3 in the number form, so that because in text form it's not readable, so in we are labeling them as 1, 2, 3. New York as 1, California as 2 and Florida as 3. Now I am installing the package CA tools. I have already installed it. You can install that with this command install.packages CA tools if you don't have it, because it's used to perform multiple linear regression operation on R. So I will run it. Now I can use the package CA tools. If I won't have run it, we can't use the CA tools package. Now set.seed 123. With the CA tools, we can run this command to set the seed. Now split equals to sample.split round bracket dataset dollar profit split ratio equals to 0.8. Now we'll train the set and subset dataset split equals to true. We'll split the data as true and false. Data is now splitted. Now fitting multiple linear regression to the training set. Regressor equals to LM, logical mean, formula equals to profit, data equals to training underscore set. It's done. Now I will see the summary of regressor, this formula that we have applied. What result will get in the output? When will apply this formula in the given data set? See. Residuals, call, logical mean, minimum first quarter, median third quarter, maximum, coefficient, estimate, standard error, t value. All these outputs we are getting as the result from the given data set. With this simple one line of code, summary, regressor. But to define regressor, we used this code where we have taken profit data, how much we have made this company. Now y underscore predictive modeling we are performing. Regressor new data equals to test underscore set. We are naming as test underscore set new data, which will predict the output from the previous data. Now building the optimal model using backward elimination. For that, regressor equals to LM, formula equals to profit, RD.spend in research and development spend plus administration plus marketing.spend plus state, data equals to data set. So it will perform the regression. And finally, with this command, we'll get the summary of regressor on all the data set which are available in this. So for data scientists and statisticians and machine learners, this can give them this simple operation on multiple linear regression can give them the result. Then you will understand naive bias. Naive bias classifiers are a collection of classification algorithms which are based on Bayes theorem. It is not a single algorithm but a family of algorithms where all of them share a common principle. That is, every pair of features being classified is independent of each other. To start with, let us consider a data set. Consider a fictional data set that describes the weather conditions for playing a game of cricket or golf or not. Whether should you play the game of cricket or not. Given the weather conditions, each tuple classifies the condition as fit. As yes, unfit as no, or 0 or 1 in machine learning form. So for that we can make prediction that we should play the game golf in such a weather condition or not. Such decisions can be taken using naive bias algorithm, which is the set of or collection of other machine learning algorithms taken together to perform a new operation and get the result. So here also I am collecting a data set which is social network ads.csv. The CSV file I am taking. Let's see what that data set is having. With this command, I will see that data set. It's having 200 values of various people and their user ID, their gender, their age, their estimated salary, and their purchases that they have made. So the naive bias algorithm we are going to perform on this data set, the CSV file. We need to take 3 to 5 values and check the data set number of rows. Once that is done, the data set which is now available purchased as 1 and not purchased as 0. We can see that. Now again I am using library CA tools. Set dot seed equals to 1, 2, 3 to perform machine learning algorithms. Split ratio equals to 0.75. Training set equals to subset data split equals to true. Test set equals to subset data set split equals to false. Now feature scaling I will do. Trainings underscore set minus 3 equals to scale training underscore set minus 3. Test underscore set minus 3 equals to scale test underscore set minus 3. This done. Now fitting classifier to training set. Create your own classifier here. For that, this library package is 1071 we are going to use. This done. Now fitting classifier to training set. Create your own classifier here. For that, this library package is 1071 we are going to use. Global environment, from that it is unmasked with this library. And now I will see the classifier. Let's check the classifier. It will give us the predicted output as the result. Naive bias classifier is performed on discrete predictions. And prediction could be made with that result. Now predicting the test set results, what we have got. The confusion matrix, for that this command we are going to use. Which will give us this output. Visualizing the training set results, library lmstatlearn. I will run this package rmstatlearn to perform more accurate predictions using naive bias algorithm. Set equals to training underscore set we are taking, which we have created already. X1 equals to sequence minimum set 1 to minus 1, maximum set 1 plus to plus 1 by 0.01. X2 also. Grid underscore set expand dot grid x1 x2. We are going to expand that grid. Column names grid underscore set where we'll name them age and estimated salary. Probab set equals to predict classifier type equals to response new data grid underscore set, and then this code we are gonna run which will perform the naive bias classification on training set. So this code you must write, it's a bit lengthy though. through which we can perform naive Bayes classifier. See, initially it was black and white. When I will run this, simply it will show the black and white output, but next we are coloring it as green and red to get the more accurate results, and it will get colored in this way. Now you can see the output. Initially the results were not that much satisfactory to make the predictions of the salary, but now the new output which we have got is in the colorful visualization form, and this new Bayes classifier on training set can give us a very accurate result as the output. Please don't forget to subscribe us to remain updated with technical videos.